So, Jen, intimate partner violence is a common diagnostic problem that we as GPs face.
Is it a common problem or is it a common problem that we miss?
It's interesting, it's both, isn't it, when you think about it, because it's one in four women experience intimate partner violence, and it's estimated the average GP sees five patients per week that present.
Five patients per week who've been affected in the last 12 months, yeah. Which overall over a lifetime is even higher than that. Yes.
So in some ways it may often be the probability diagnosis.
Yes, so if we're thinking about the diagnosis in terms of Murtaugh's diagnostic strategy, it may be the more obvious probability diagnosis in certain circumstances. What things would raise that for you?
I think the common example would be the patient with recurrent presentations with physical symptoms, mm-hmm. that seem to have no obvious cause. Mm-hmm. I think it certainly should pass through your mind as a diagnostic probability in that circumstance, and even one of the more common diagnostic possibilities.
So in that circumstance, it's the probability diagnosis, but it's also, is the patient trying to tell me something? Is this an underlying cause of a presentation that the patient, that the woman can't quite bring herself to verbalise to you?
Yeah, and that may take her some time to feel comfortable to present that. So I think it is one of those classic consultations where we talk through a problem, and then at the last minute, just as the patient's about to leave, they give you some clue as to the diagnostic possibility of intimate partner violence. And that's one of the important circumstances where we really do need to take that cue as an opportunity and spend the time to establish whether or not our concerns may be founded.
Yes. And trust is such an important part of the doctor-patient relationship at all times, and especially in this case when she's actually developed the trust to disclose this to you, to validate your concerns and take them seriously. So that's, I guess, the probability diagnosis can suggest itself with somebody who presents often with medically unexplained symptoms, and it might be the last, the by the way doctor thing that comes out with that. I guess it's a...
I actually think it's a pitfall.
So one of the red flags that's...
One of the issues that is commonly missed, and again the big lesson of my life as a clinician, both as a GP and an emergency physician, is if you're aware of the pitfalls, they don't trick you. Mm. And once you think about the possibility, and once you realise that this is a pitfall, that you address it. Mm. And so in these sorts of presentations, such as depression, recurrent physical symptoms, recurrent abdominal pain,
headaches, pelvic pain,
all of those sorts of things, I think it's a pitfall. It's important for it to pass through your mind. Am I missing this opportunity? Is this a diagnostic possibility in this instance?
So moving it from something that's often missed to something that we are actually picking up because we're considering the possibility. Yeah.
So once you consider the possibility, it is possible to address it, isn't it? If you feel like you can do something. So
yes, if you bring it out in the open, then you can offer assistance, you can help the woman to recognise the fact that what she is experiencing is violence, that it's inappropriate, that it shouldn't happen to her, that it's not her fault. So once you bring it out into the open and acknowledge the problem, acknowledge the difficulty, then you can offer the woman opportunities to address it and deal with the problem.
So remembering that part of the power that her partner has over her is the power of secrecy.
Right, yeah.
And once we bring this problem that's hidden out into the open, there's a possibility to address it.
Yes, you can unmask it and do something about it. I guess the other thing, the probability diagnosis becomes very much more obvious if there's obvious injury, and that would make you consider it very early whether the woman offers it or not. If she presents with injuries that really don't have it, she can't explain, would make you consider it.
That's an interesting analogy you make there, Jen, because psychological injury is sometimes just as obvious. Post-traumatic stress disorder, depression, unexplained anxiety, these are all manifest...
Eating disorders, drug use.
Absolutely, that these are significant injuries or traumas, if you like, that are a red flag for the possibility of intimate partner violence.
And I guess in terms of what's the important diagnosis not to miss when we're thinking, you know, what's the probability to diagnosis, what's not to miss? Well, domestic violence has to come up there in that list of things not to miss.
Absolutely. It's, what is it, one or two women every week are killed through domestic violence.
Is it that high?
It's that high.
It's really sobering, isn't it?
Yeah. And I guess we need to remember that... the importance of safety netting in that circumstance, just as we would safety net a patient that presented to us with abdominal pain.
Mm-hmm.
We need to think about safety netting of our patients with intimate partner violence by exploring how safe are they.
Mm-hmm. Yes, good point. So if we're looking overall at Murtaugh's diagnostic strategy, we need to consider it as part of the probability diagnosis.
Yes.
What's the most likely diagnosis in this presentation? What's the most important diagnosis not to miss? It might be the domestic violence issue. Is it something that's often missed? And I think as a GP, I realise how often in retrospect I have overlooked the diagnosis and not considered it or not pursued it adequately. Is it a masquerade? Absolutely. Is the patient trying to tell me something?
So all five arms of Murtaugh's criteria, diagnostic strategy, really intimate partner violence warrants thinking about under all five possibilities.
And it's a good framework in which to consider the problem in relation to the person presenting in front of you.
Because if you think about the diagnosis and pursue it with a patient, you probably make the diagnosis.
Think about it.
Think about it.
And don't be afraid to ask.